Hi, that's me. My name's Sabrina Cruz. I'm a YouTuber, and May 5th was a weird day in my life. Because it wasn't a day in my life. It was a day in hers.
My name is Kira Grünberg. I'm 25 years old, and I'm ambassador for the Wings for Life program.
The Wings for Life Foundation raises money for spinal cord research. Their main fundraiser is the Wings for Life World Run. Whether it's through the app or at an event, people around the world start running at the exact same time. They're running for people who can't, for people like Kira.
So you've led a very interesting life. Could you tell us a bit about it?
I was a former pole vaulter. I did athletics and yeah, I think I was quite good at it. I'm the record holder in Austria. And 2015, I had an accident during my training session. I broke my fifth cervical, and since that time, I'm paralyzed from the chest down.
So after your accident, how did your life change?
Yeah, it was a big change for me because I need a lot of help now. I'm not able to do things by myself. Yeah, all my goals, like being a world champion or being a European champion, it's not possible anymore. So I had to set new goals for my life.
But luckily, you do have a lot of help in your life, right? You've got your family over here.
That's true, yes, yes. I'm really, really happy that I have such lovely people around me.
So you mentioned your life goals. Have they changed since then?
They have changed. A big goal is just to live a normal life, just not to be a world champion or to be the best in something, just living a life that it's worth living.
So I guess that's the perfect segue into Wings for Life. So could you tell me a little bit about the Wings for Life Foundation?
Yeah, Wings for Life is collecting money for research to help people that are paralyzed, people that are with a spinal cord injury. It's a really nice event because all the people today are running for us, for people who are not able to run again. So yeah. It's really, really nice.
Could you tell me a bit about how Wings for Life has affected your life?
Yeah, it's a really, really big community. There are a lot of people that are also paralyzed, and yeah, it's nice to meet them every year. And yeah, I hope soon there are some effects of the research.
So, today is the big day, today is the run. Since I am new to running, I'm very nervous, and I'm gonna need your support as a seasoned veteran. So could you give me some advice for succeeding in the Wings for Life?
I think the best advice is not to start too fast, because all the people are running really, really fast at the first kilometers, and you're going to be tired after 1 or 2 kilometers, and just enjoy the really great feeling. I can't describe it because it's really, really nice.
Well, fortunately, you will be able to help remind me not to run too fast at the beginning, because we will be running the first 2 kilometers together, right?
I will remember you. You don't have to be nervous. It's going to be really easy.
I think that you are overestimating how good I am at running.
Yeah, it's not the goal to be fast or running 20 or 50 kilometers. It's just for the fun and for Wings for Life.
Yeah. It's really wonderful. Even though I'm really nervous, I'm not scared that people will judge me, because
no,
this event has been very welcoming and opening.
Exactly.
Now, this is my first year running, so I turned to Kira for a little bit of help getting started. We were gonna run the first kilometer together. She was going to let me push her. Why only 1 kilometer, you ask? Well, I just genuinely didn't know if I could run any more than that. So, I'm standing at the starting line with Kira and her team of expert runners. As the run ticks closer, Kira is just staring down the long road ahead, this track of potentially infinite length. And I keep asking her, "Are you ready?" And she keeps laughing and saying, "Yeah," and I keep thinking, "I'm not." And then the countdown started, in German. I'm pretty sure that I was the only person there who didn't speak German. Literally 1 second before the run, I was worried that I was gonna start running way too early or way too late. But then the clock hit 0, and all of that panic vanished. I was just running. We were literally on a roll. I was just focused on straight ahead. And maybe that was my mistake. We rolled right over a tram line at full speed, and I felt this jarring shake from my arms to my head. And I realized that I needed to be more careful. When you're on wheels, you can't just look up and ahead. You need to look all around you. After that, I was on high alert. And I started to notice that people were running so, so, so much faster than us. And honestly, I was starting to feel like an inconvenience, like this unwanted stone in the current of the run. Except people would come around to say hello, to cheer Kira on, pulling us forward with the power of a thumbs up and a smile. And eventually, Kira's team took over to take her further than me and my asthmatic lungs could ever even dream. And my day out of my life was over. But I learned something. I feel like I understand just the smallest bit better what it means to live life in a wheelchair. And until Wings for Life achieves its goal of curing spinal cord injury, I hope you remember the biggest lesson I learned that day. And that is just how powerful a little bit of patience and a little bit of kindness can be.